toad, avoiding damnable decision, avoiding damnable decision. But there are many things you and I are going through today as a result of the decision we made yesterday. You and I only have power over decision when it's yet to be made. Before decision is made, it's left to you. But immediately you make that decision, you become a slave to the decision you have made. For you not to be a slave to what you yourself have, the decision you have made, you better make the right decision. So that the decision you have made today will not be tormenting you tomorrow. That's why in hell today, the soul that in hell can never blame Jesus Christ. No one is crying in hell saying, "Ah, I came to Jesus Christ and he refused me." No. No one is saying, "Jesus, you are the reason why I am here." No. Everyone there are blaming themselves. If I had known, I would have made such decision. If I had knew, I would have done so thing. And by then, it would have been too late to cry when the head is off. That's why the Bible is telling you and I now in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. In Proverbs 3, verse 5, that we should trust in the Lord with all our heart and lean not in thy own understanding. Trust in the Lord in all your heart, in everything. Trust in the Lord. But it's not left for you to make the decision within yourself that I will not trust him. I have to manipulate myself into whatever I want to do. But the Lord in his mercy have counseled you and I. Trust me in everything with all your heart. And let not your understanding, your shallow understanding destroy you. But it's not left for you to say, no, I better use my human wisdom and send myself to hell. It's a decision. And we are told in Isaiah chapter 30, verse 21, and the ear shall hear a word behind you. This is God for you. The Lord will never leave his children comfortless. He will never leave his children in the dark. He said, and their ears shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the right way. He always does. The Lord always tells us the right thing to do. There's always a still voice that will tell you, this is the right thing to do. Do it this way. Walk ye in it. When you turn to the right hand and when you turn to the left. But the Lord have given you also, given me also the power to reject him and to accept him. That is decision. The Lord did not create us as robots. No. He created us as people who have the ability to make decisions. Either to reject what he has said or accept it. Either to accept it or reject it. He said, but I have told you, my daughter, I will always counsel you. I have told you, my son, I will always tell you this is the right thing to do. This is the right man you ought to marry. It's not left for you to marry that man because it is handsome and that kill you tomorrow. This is the right thing you ought to do in order to call to me heaven. It's not left for you to do it or to follow your own way. And today, many of us are regretting the actions of yesterday, though there was a still voice inside of us telling us this action you are about to take is a wrong action. But because we need that thing at that momentary pleasure, we follow it. And today, momentary pleasure has taken so many hours, days, weeks, years of torment in our lives. Brethren, it's written in Proverbs chapter number 3, verse 6. In all thy ways, in all thy ways, acknowledge him. Is God not merciful? Is God not kind to us? He have told you and I, in all our ways, my children, acknowledge me. Put the thing on the table for me. Let me wait it for you and tell you what you ought to do. But no, we will not allow, we will not do so. In many ways, we think we are able to do it our own way without consulting him. By saying, if you will do it, you will have a peaceful life, a joyful life, a joyful home, life without stress. If we acknowledge him in all our ways, and he shall direct our path. If we have acknowledged him in that marriage, the Lord have directed us what to do. If we have acknowledged him in that decision that is now become a torment to you and I now, I tell you something, the Lord would have directed our path of what to do. And the Lord cannot direct you and you will delay. It's not possible. You know why? You know the end from the beginning. You know what you and I are about to face. That's why he's saying, my children, you know nothing. Always bring it before me, and I will tell you what the end of it will be. But today now, many of us, we have become prayer warriors in the night. Praying over what you're not supposed to be praying over. Many of us, we are now running helter-skelter over things that were avoidable, over avoidable destruction, over avoidable pain. Now, we are in it. What do? We still run back to the God that we neglected yesterday. And I pray, Lord, have mercy upon me and have mercy upon you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Bible told us in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 26 to 27. He's saying, I have forgiven you all your sin. I have purged you. I have done everything to pull you out of sin into his marvelous light. I've done everything to make sure I die for you and that you should come to me. But listen, if we sin willfully, decision. You know it's a sin. You know what you're about to do is a sin. You know this is what you cry about yesterday, and he has forgiven you. If you now do it willfully, after that we have received the knowledge of the truth, decision. There remaineth no more sacrifice for sins. Know why? If you make that decision and death happens to meet you at that moment, no more sacrifice again. The person is doomed forever. That's why nobody blame God in hell. Nobody blame Christ in hell. Everyone in hell are blaming themselves. Why? Because they took a decision that derailed their souls in hell. 27. But a certain fearful looking for judgment and fearing indignation, we shall devour the adversary. You that is alive now, the Lord is telling you, will you always bring your decision to me? Let me be doing and making it for you, because we know nothing. So that you not join the queue of those who are lamenting here now. As we are talking right now, people are jumping into it like rainfall. You know what? Get this. No matter how we pray, no matter how we fast, our day will surely come. Today now, it's our time to say, Lord, I thank you because you allow us to see this day. A day is coming. We'll never pray that prayer again. Somebody else will also be saying, ah, Lord, I thank you because you have allowed us to see this day. If I stay too much again, and maybe, I don't know, maybe another 60 years or another 50 years, I'm gone. And I will never say again, God, I thank you for another day. I will be in eternity where I have decided to send myself to. The Lord will never tell anybody not to go to his kingdom. It's not left for us to live the life that will open the gate of heaven for you and I, or live the life that will open the gate of hell. Decision you make matters. But then we are told in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 3 and 4. The Bible pre-informed your eye. What is about to happen? It's not left for you to join this queue or no. Say, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. When they will make a decision not to endure sound doctrine. Not that they don't know it's a sound doctrine. Not that they don't know it's true. Not that they don't know this is the word that will send them to heaven. but they decide not to follow it. When they shall not endure sound doctrine, but after their own decision, after their own lust, shall they heap to themselves teachers having itch ears. That's why people are running into churches now where they'll be comforted in their sin. Running away from pastors who will teach them the truth, who will pull them away from tomorrow's decision. But running into pastors that will make them happy now, momentarily happy. They want to be joyful in their sin now. So even though they know the pastor is lying to them, just tell it to us. We understand you are lying, but so Lord is giving me joy now. Say it. But you that will tell them the word of pain there now and give them joy tomorrow and ever after, they will run away from you. You see, the hour is now. Think about yourself. In verse 4, and they shall turn away their ear. They shall turn. It's not that somebody else did. They by themselves, they will make their own decision to turn their ears away from the truth. My dear, they know it's the truth. They know this is what we said to heaven, but they have decided to turn their ears away from it and shall be turned unto Fable by their own selves. They have done this. And that is what is happening today. People have decided by themselves to walk into hell, majestically laughing and joyful into hell. I pray that will not be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So what do? We Bible says in Romans chapter 6, verse 12, let not sin, therefore, let not. You have the power to do it. The power is in your hands. Let not sin, therefore, reign in your mortal body, that ye should obey it in the lust thereof. Let not sin reign in your mortal body. It means you have the power to say, sin, you will not reign in it. That's what Apostle Paul said, I have subjected my body to myself. Lest when I have preached to the people, I will not be a castaway. By itself, it took that decision to subject himself to subject his body to himself. I know this thing, when I do it, it will provide money, but I will not do it because it will ruin my soul. I know if I preach this way, this ministry will be full, but I know within me, what about when the ministry is not full, the church is not full, and I'm enjoying luxurious life, and at the end I die, what will become of me? Because of this, I will not do so. That's why we are told in that same Romans 6, verse 16, they know ye not. Don't you know? Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourself, servant to obey. You yield yourself, you decided to. You are the one that make the decision to do it. Know ye not that to whom you yield yourself, servant to obey. The servant ye shall be, the servant ye are, to whom ye obey, whether of sin or to death. That decision to sin is unto death. Or of obedience unto righteousness. The choice is yours. We are free moral agents that have the ability to decide either to yield ourselves to sin, to become servant to sin, or to yield ourselves to obedience to God and live a free life with Christ and make heaven on that day. Holiness is a choice. Righteousness is a choice. Worldliness is a choice. And the Lord have given you and I the power to choose. You go to the market to steal, it's your choice. Take it and put it in your pocket, it's your choice. Leave it there because it's not your own, it's your choice. You are walking on the street, you see money on the ground, it's your choice. To either take it or not to take it, it's your choice. Connecting this money, the Lord don't come out and flog you and say, I build a favor. Connect now. No. It was your choice to connect this money to hear the word of God. And if you have decided to sleep and sleep all through the day, it's your choice. It's your choice. So, But be careful not to make a choice that will slay us tomorrow. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
As I said before, in that Romans 6, verse 12, it says, let not sin therefore in your mortal body, that ye should obey it in the law thereof. 13, neither yield your member as instrument of unrighteousness, unto sin, decision, but yield yourselves unto God as those that are alive from the dead, and your member as instrument of righteousness unto God. This is a very wonderful counsel. It's not left for you and I to follow the counsel of God or follow our crafty counsel and face the consequence on the last day. The Bible has told you and I that for all shall come to the Lord on that day and give account of themselves. We all shall give account of the decision we make now. You will not say it was because of my husband. No. Your husband can only suggest to you to do it is your decision. Your wife can only suggest to you, my husband, there's no phone in this house, go and steal. It's not left with us, okay? I have to go and do something to make money, or I have to go and steal to please you. That's why nobody blame anybody. You will not go to say, God, it was because of my husband. If you say it, that is another punishment. For you to have given your reasonable faculty, your decision-making ability into somebody's hand, is another punishment. That's why you must be careful not to allow somebody to derail your soul. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
By the Bible, God in his mercy have outlined what will destroy us. It's not left for us to yield ourselves to it. In Galatians chapter 5, verse 19. Then, say, now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: idolatry, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, 20, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulation, wrath, strife, seduction, heresies, envy, murder, drunkenness, revealing, and such like, as such which I tell you before, as I have also told you in the past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. You are told. It's not left for you and I to still go and do it. The Lord will only advise you and I. My daughter, this is what we send you to her. My son, this is what we send you to my kingdom. It's not left for you to say, Lord, I know who I am. I am a grown-up man. I can decide what I have to do to myself. Nobody should talk to me. Say, okay. You are free to your decision. Check yourself now. Is envy not there? Check yourself now. All these things that are outlined here, are they not found in you and I? It's a decision to be envious. It's a decision to see somebody doing something. You are jealous about it. You want to kill yourself for it. It's a decision. Or it's a decision to say, Lord, I thank you for what you are giving me. I thank you for the grace you're giving me. I better hold on to what I have. Let those who are driving limousine, whatever. Lord, I give you all the praise because you have told me I should be contented with what I have. It's a decision. Or to be killing myself over what somebody else had. I thank you, Lord, because you have blessed this sister with that wonderful voice. But you said, let every feet that have breath praise the Lord. It means you have also given my own voice. I will praise you the way you are giving me the voice. Or you'll be fighting Sister Echo for having such a voice. It's not left for you. It's not left for you. Hold on to what you have or kill yourself over what somebody else had. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
In verse 22. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such, there is no law. Against such, there's no life. So it's not left for you to remove love and put hatred there and be hating people. It's a decision. It's not left for you to remove joy there and be carrying your head as if you are fighting with the whole nation. It's not left for you. It's not left for you to be living your life in hatred. It's not left for you to allow the Prince of Peace to take over you or allow the devil to take over you. Everything is there. It's not left for you to have this sort of long suffering, to patiently wait for God to do what you want to do. To say, Lord, you have told me in the book of Job chapter 40, verse 15, if a man die, will he live again? All the days of years of my appointed shall I wait until my church come. It's not left for you to allow God to patiently do your own. Or you jump out of it and enter into what you want to do. And enjoy today and face tomorrow's destruction. It's not left for you to allow your gentleness to take over you. Oh, you are lofty. You want to be known. You can call your mother-in-law and insult her. You can call your father-in-law because why? Because you are in Europe. Because you're in America. You can speak American English. Now you not take your people in the family as though they are nothing. It's not left for you to humble yourself, to be gentle, or to live the life recklessly you want to live. Goodness, it's not left for you to be like Christ. The Bible says how God anointed Jesus Christ with Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good for God was with him, and healing all that were sick, for God was with him. Or you are going about as a tale bearer, going about causing confusion, going about doing evil. It's not left for you. The Lord Jesus Christ came on this earth. In Philippians chapter 2, from verse 1 down to 11, he decided to humble himself, to become like a servant to the people he created. He humbled himself before them. It's not left for you and I to begin to write on people. And the Bible has told you and I, and the cloud of witnesses are waiting to give to tell you that thing you were doing. I had opportunity to do it, but I make a decision not to do it. Check yourself now. What is that decision you have taken that is sending you to hell? What is that decision I have taken and sending me to hell? Many of us, we know that those things they are saying is true. You know, I have told you that waiting as a woman is a sin. You understand, yet you want to put it on because you want people to see you as a wonderful, as a beautiful woman. You want to put yourself on those things, please yourself. It's a decision you are taking. Please, whatever decision you are taking, make sure you do it very, very well. Know why? So that when you are not suffering for it, you will know when you will eat, you will enjoy it in full. If you have made the decision to be holy, please make sure you soak yourself into that holiness. And if you also make a decision to be worldly, please do it with all your heart. Don't try to sit at the fence. No. It's whichever one you have decided to do, do it fully. So that when the time comes, we are enjoying heaven, you say, yes, the pain I went through on earth was really much. Now, enjoyment galore. Or when you are not born in hell, you remember how you enjoy yourself, like the rich man on earth. You remember how you used to enjoy. You remember that the brothers and sisters are still enjoying now. He cried out and said, those my brother, I have five brothers. Father, have mercy upon them. Do you also want to get to hell before realizing that the life you live on earth was dangerous? Then you will not be crying for those who are living it now. And there you will ever be forever. Whatever enter hell is equal to hell. Anything that enter hell become a fire won't be hell. Everything in hell burns. The intestines are all burning. Anything in hell are to be fire in hell. So we must take a decision not to go there. That's why the Bible has told us in James chapter 4, verse 17. Therefore, to him that knoweth to do good, sister, brother, you know that thing is good or evil. As little as my children is now, they know when they are doing the right thing and when they are doing the wrong thing. And Sister Abiola Favor that is up going to almost 40-something, will not tell me what she wants to do, she don't know. It's a lie, she don't know. Ma, you know. Sister Esther rejoice, you know. We know what is sin. We know when we are taking evil against somebody. We know when we are about to take wrong actions. We know. But he said, therefore, to him that knoweth to do good, and doeth it not, to him it's a sin. You know this thing, as you are enjoying it, is good for you. And you don't want somebody else to enjoy it, and you are saying you want to make everything a lie. Like, you know, if I hurt, if I be hurt, I will not be happy. And I will make the decision to hurt you. And yet I'm still saying, Lord, on that day, remember me is a lie. To him that know the right to do, and do it not to him, is a sin. And no sinner is found in heaven. Now, God is telling you and I in his word, in Romans 6, verse 18, be them made from sin. Be them made free from sin. Yea, become the servant of righteousness now. Yesterday, we were the servant of sin. But the Lord, in his mercy, have decided to make an act free now from sin. Do we make the decision again to go back to sin again? That's why our brother Joshua, he gathered his people and said, come on. You and I know the life we live at the back of Jordan. We know the evil we did there. Do you decide to go back now to live that life? Choose ye this day. If those beggarly element life idol we serve in Egypt, not to serve, follow, decision. But as for me and my house, we'll serve the Lord. It was a choice for the people that Noah was building ark to save, to join with him and carve the ark and enter, or to come and be making mockery of him while the ark is being carved. To the decision. He told them, rain is coming. They saw him build the ark. They decided to make mockery. Hey, see old man, bad hair. See you, bad, you a jobless man. In his joblessness, we are doing the job that will save his soul, the family. Glory be to God. The family followed him. For the animals. Animals now make the right decision that a human being could not make. That's why you see now. See what is happening today. Why men are fighting themselves. When land you pass and see dog fighting. When land you pass again and see animal fighting. The animal now have learned to make the right decision. Why human beings are making the foolery of themselves. Human beings are killing themselves, raping themselves, destroy themselves. But animals that are supposed to be foolish, they are now working together majestically. Is it not surprising? The act that human being rejected, the animals enter into it, they were saved. No wonder the Bible says, on the last day, people from the east, west, and north will enter the kingdom, or the children of the kingdom that decided to jump out of the kingdom by themselves to be left behind. Decision. Decision. There's 20 of Romans 6. For when you were the servant of sin, you were free from righteousness. 21. What fruit had he then in those things whereof ye are now ashamed? For the end of those things is death. Though they are supposed to be ashamed of it, no, they are not ashamed. They are still living in it, enjoying it. You were ashamed of that sin when you were confessing it. Why did you go back to it again? If it was the right thing, why were you confessing? Lord, have mercy upon me. Oh, Lord, what I did now. But after confession, we go back to it again. What have come over your eye? The heart of the devil. The Lord will deliver your eye in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Verse 23. For the wages of sin is death. The wages of that decision you have taken now to sin against Christ, to sin against your soul, is death. But glory be to God, for the gift of God is eternal life. Grab it now. What is that gift of God? Salvation. holiness, righteousness, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And I pray, there are a lot of sin, stop there because of time. I pray, the Lord will help me and you. Whatever decision we are about to take now, or we have taken already, about to manifest it, about to work on it, may the Lord touch us and show us again the consequence of that decision. Or maybe there's something you are going through now because of what you did yesterday. I pray the Lord will have mercy upon you, have mercy upon me, and cancel the error of yesteryears, and start a new life with us, and give all that sort of humbleness to always table everything before Him, for we do it to the end that you and I will secure our souls in heaven on the last day. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
God has spoken to you. He led those that have ears and they hear what the Spirit is saying. I want to say, Father, check my file of yesterday and today. And see all the decisions I've ever taken. It's not robbing me of my soul. Have mercy upon me. Wash me. I need a brand new fight today. Let a new beginning start with me today. And give me this sort of humbleness to always table everything before you. And whenever you tell me what to do, the grace to always do it releases upon me now. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and pray. The Bible told us in Romans 8:6, for to be carnally minded, decision. Be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Make a decision today. Either, Lord, help me to be spiritually minded, or Lord, I'm comfortable with my carnally mindedness. Open your mouth and make a decision. Lord, from now on, I want to be spiritually minded. Or, Lord, help me to be more carnal in my doings. Open your mouth and pray.
I want to be
And as we have prayed, by the mercy of God, so shall it be in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Now that you have heard the word of the Lord, it's time of decision making now. Are you out there? You're not born again. Make a decision to remain where you are now, or to run to the open hands of Christ that is open for you now. Confess and say before Him and accept Him as your Lord and personal Savior. Maybe you were born again, you backslided because of some issues. It's not left for you to remain in that backslid state now. Or run to God now as a sheep gone astray, coming back to the shepherd and the bishop of his soul. Or her soul. Make a decision. Whatever decision you have made now will be what will stand for you on the last day. As many of us that have made the decision to come back to Christ and to be born again, I welcome you into the holy food of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I pray the Lord will preserve your soul, will help you from now on. Every decision you'll be making will be the one that will guide your soul into His kingdom. And the joy that you have brought to heaven today will never ever become sorrow and tears tomorrow in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I join you by the mercy of God that you present yourself to get baptized so that you'll be buried with him and resurrected with him. If you wish to do so, please, all the ministers of this mountain, by the mercy of God, we are ready. We use by the mercy of God to get you baptized. And I pray the Lord God Almighty will help you. Help me. And this message will not be used against me on the last day. It's better said to be done than to do it. I pray the Lord help me to practice what I'm preaching. Help my co-minister so that on the last day will not be cast away, will not be a signboard on that day. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Bless this morning. Why don't you give a clap of it to the Lord Jesus Christ for the blessing? Amen.
Amen.